happened, Pinky? We didn't do her pinky. Pinky.
That's all right.
Why? What's the matter? What's the matter? Easy, girl. What's the matter? It's all right. It's your mom. I'm your mom. Good morning and welcome to the Funny Farm Rescue and Sanctuary located in Mays Landing, New Jersey. We are 45 minutes from Atlantic City and about an hour south of Philadelphia. I have a very special guest here today. This is Pinky. Oh, she's so excited that she's on the live, right? She is about 4 month old emu. Pinky is needed to be rescued because she has what they call splay legs. Can you see how it looks cruel? But let me stand up with her. She has to have her legs kind of hobbled. So there's something here to keep her legs separated, and then her tape so she can still walk, but yet she can't splay her legs out. So being a splay leg means when she stands up, her leg goes whoop, like in the cartoons, and the leg goes straight out, and it will keep growing that way, and they become very large birds. They get about 140 pounds, I believe, and they have to hold all that weight. They have little tiny, tiny wings. It's like an ostrich, but the next size down, so it's the second largest bird in the world. Here's the wings. They cannot fly, but they run about 40 miles an hour. And as you know, for those that have been here, we have Emily the emu. Mommy emus aren't so great. They try and stomp on babies, so we can't let Emily take care of her. So, of course, now she's living in my kitchen. Where else would we put an emu, a baby emu, right? And she's very sweet. I think she's a little upset right now because we're on TV, but usually she just sits nicely in her bed on top of my kitchen table. She's in a big dog crate right now. She is eating really well, and we hope that this hobble that we're doing on her legs can fix her up, so then eventually she'll be an outside emu, not an inside emu. And she's getting used to all the dogs and the kitty cats and the other animals here at the Funny Farm. So she has not been outside yet, other than when she was born. She was at a farm and they said that she had splay legs and, you know, they usually would euthanize her. But I said, let me give it a whirl and let's try and save her life and make it better. So her name is Pinky because she originally had pink duct tape on her legs. I had since changed her dressing, her hobble, to be black duct tape because the pink wasn't sticky enough and she was ripping right through it because they have such strong legs. An emu could actually kick you and kill you when they're full grown. So even as babies, they're very, very, very strong. So you have to always be careful. They also get like almost like razors on the back of their legs here. If you look at their feet, they're like prehistoric. They look like something out of Jurassic Park. And back here, they eventually will get these little razors on their. All right, let me see if you're just uncomfortable. You want to sit up different? Okay, look, there you go. She wants to sit how she wants to sit. She's like, Mom, don't push me anywhere. Don't hold me down. Just let me sit here.
You should have named her Lori.
Shut up, Matt. Or be quiet, Matt. I shouldn't, you know. It's not polite to say shut up.
Thank you. So Debbie Carr is watching from Idaho, and she says that she likes your hair today. And she said something else, but I forgot. Oh, welcome back, Matt.
Thank you, Debbie. I decided not to wear a hat today because inside it gets a little darker. It is not raining today now at the Funny Farm, but it rained all morning. So if you come to visit, we're open 8 to 4, Sundays and Tuesdays. It was also National Volunteer Appreciation Week last week. So we're celebrating it this week. Of course, let the Funny Farm be a week late, right? So we want to thank all those volunteers that help us each and every day. We are all volunteer run. We have no paid people. Some people walk around and say, how do you do it? They think I do it by myself. I'm like, I used to when there was like 200 animals, but now that there's 600 plus animals, I have helpers every single day. We have a few. If anybody wants to volunteer Tuesdays and Sundays, if you can bring any skills to the tables, we always need carpenter type people, electricians. There's a lot of pens that need to be, you know, the enclosures need to be fixed up because the goats decide they want to hit them with their horns and they bust up some of the pens. So we're forever, it's like a continuous cycle where we're always fixing them. So
Susan Sheldon from the UK is watching.
Susan Sheldon from the UK. Yay. Thanks for watching. Speaking of splay legs, I want to give an update on Buddy. He doesn't have a splay leg, but he had a femur break a couple weeks ago. He jumped up when he saw a dog on television and he wanted to bark at it. So he went to the University of Penn. We've got his leg pinned, plated, screwed, wired, and he was doing great. Last Tuesday, he was running almost on the leg like he normally would, and we had somebody's toddler fall on Buddy's leg. Thank goodness it didn't break it, but however, we don't know if it just, the kid falling on him, you know, helped the screw to come out or the pin. So the pin backed out, unfortunately, and it started to cause him a lot of pain. So he was holding his leg up, running, you know, still running around, but with his one leg up. So we knew something was wrong. We had to get him back in University of Penn. Hopefully, Nikki, shush. We hope to be doing, getting the surgery done today, but it's an emergency basis and they're having lots of other emergencies there, unfortunately. So we're hoping that he gets surgery today because he's in a lot of pain. So everybody say a little prayer for Buddy and hope he's doing okay. He's one of the oldest Funny Farm dogs. He is the oldest Funny Farm dog. He's 10 years old, right, Matt?
Yeah.
So he has become, he was Matt's dog, but now he's become a Funny Farm dog because he's, even when Matt goes home to New York, Buddy stays here. So he's a Funny Farm dog now. he can't be without all his brothers and sisters. He just loves them too much. Okay. Here's Steve, one of my kitty cats. There's about 20 cats in the house. This cat was adopted out as a kitten. The woman had a baby and went nuts. Just like the dog Nala, which we're going to talk about in a minute. They had a baby and decided they were so afraid that the cat would scratch the baby that they brought the cat back, which I always say, if it doesn't work out, the animals can come back. And he was scared to death. He wasn't really happy or friendly at first, but now he is very well adjusted and always wants to see what's going on. What happened?
I don't know. We need Teresa back.
So Matt's back from New York. Thank you, Tree, for filling in last week. You can see Matt's having all sorts of issues. Tree had no issues.
Yeah, Tree did good. She says hello. She's
Tree's watching. Thank you, Tree. Tree
says her real name, Tree.
I know. We should have said Matt, you know. So speaking of legs, so it's all about legs today. So we have, if anybody's just tuning in, we have the baby emu here named Pinky. Tucker is upset. All the dogs are outside, obviously. You can hear Tucker barking, maybe. Nikki's trying to get on camera. You want to show her real fast? Hi. Nikki, hello. Say good morning. Hello. Hello, Nick. What, cat got your tongue? Of course, now she's not going to say anything now that she's like, I just want it to be shown. Now I'm camera shy.
So Crystal Burgett from Idaho says she loves what you do and she's raised emus for 14 years.
Get out, Crystal. I've had my one emu for a very long time, but I really didn't know what I was doing, of course. And when I started the Funny Farm in 2000, there wasn't the internet. Yeah, I know, I'm showing my age. So we had to get books and learn from other people, but I really didn't have somebody helping me. My mom taught me everything that I knew. And everything else I had to read up on. Now we have the internet, thank goodness. But you can't believe everything you read on the internet too, so you should always look at a couple sources. So this baby emu is about 4 months old, and there's an emu farm not far from here, and they have over 100 emu there. And the owner, Bill, told me about the splay-legged little girl. They did a DNA test to find out it's a female. And they were trying to figure out what to do. So he had come to visit as part of the concierge group. Thank you, concierge group, for coming. They tell people what to do in the area, and they visited us to see if it was something that they wanted to tell people about, and they loved it. So he told me about his baby emu, and I said, let's give it a chance here at the Funny Farm. We've helped lots of other splay-legged critters. So here is a baby turkey. Hold on there, girlfriend, boyfriend, we're not sure yet. So you can see, oh, he's got a little bit of a poop attached to his butt.
Oh, nice.
Mommy's not afraid to touch it, though. Never. All right, all right, all right. So you can see his...
Like a milk dud.
His milk dud, yes. We're raising that. So this, you can... Okay, she's cheering for the bird. Yay! So this turkey, you can see actually how his leg is being turned out. Actually, it's this leg. No, both of them are out a little bit. I think this one's straight and this one's turned out. So we have to pull it in a little bit more. From him walking, he has separated his hobble a bit. It's much better than it was. So he can stand it. We're on a cushy couch. But you can see he's even up a little bit, but his leg is still out. So we need to pull that in a bit. So every day we're adjusting his little hobble. Oh, somebody's cleaning herself. Excuse me, am I in your way? So this turkey came from Tractor Supply. One of our visitors got, I think, three of them. Two passed away, and then this one had a hobble leg. So she was crying when she brought it because, you know, it was the only survivor. And then he had this issue, and they were afraid they wouldn't be able to help him out enough. So they brought him to us. And they're coming. Pinky the emu, Tommy the turkey. We also had a baby mallard duck brought to us with a broken leg. And when it was brought to us, we knew it had to go to Cedar Run. You're not supposed to keep wild animals. So that actually went to a wildlife rehabilitator. Vicky Schmidt is my vice president, and she took him, and I'm not sure if he's going up to Cedar Run or not, but I needed a box at the time. Matt, you want to hand me the book?
Oh, yeah.
So there was a box sitting in my kitchen for, I don't know how long, a couple days maybe, and I opened it up because it was a small box, and I just didn't get around to it, and look what was inside. I was so excited. It came from the publisher. It says advanced reader copy, but it's my autobiography. It's called Funny Farm, My Unexpected Life with 600 Rescue Animals. This is not for sale yet. It doesn't come out till September 7th. There are no photos in it yet. I think in the middle there will be a little photo section, but it's a regular novel, and then inside will be some photos eventually. But they just sent this to me to show what it's going to look like. There'll be an author picture here, which is not there yet. And there are some changes. This was the last, before the last go-round, this is what they had printed and sent to me. It never told me. The publisher never even told me. So I found them. I'm like, look what happens when you're looking for a box for a baby duck. So we were very excited. We got 15 copies, and it's going to go to the places that will be selling them so they know about the book if somebody asks about them in my area. So that's, so you cannot buy them, unfortunately. And it's advanced reader copy, so there's some changes after this was printed. But just to kind of give you an idea, Matt was telling me they're only being in hardback right now, but they eventually will have the paperback. But this is what the cover looks like.
Hardback and ebooks.
Hardback and ebooks. And we do pre-orders, but they will not be out until September 7th. We are going to have a book signing here, and we will sell them in our store in September or October. Probably September. We're going to have to do it.
Yeah.
We're going to, I don't know what day that is, but we'll figure it out. But just so you know, thank you for everybody who's supportive. It's kind of crazy.
It's how the Funny Farm came to be.
It's how the Funny Farm came to be, and my little bit crazy upbringing of life.
All of that contributed to how it started, right?
Yeah. So the Funny Farm is the way that the Funny Farm is because of the way I was raised and what happened in early
Brenda
years.
Brenda Wallace already ordered her copy.
Thank you, Brenda Wallace. I saw a lot of you ordered your copies already. Thank you so much. The publisher hasn't even done, a whole lot yet with their pre-order. Sometimes they announce things, and I don't even think they've done an announcement yet. I think they put it out, and then we announced it, and that's how some of them got pre-ordered. So
yeah, I'm sure they will.
Update on Nala. Nala, it was the German Shepherd. We said Nyla, N-Y-L-A. It's really Nala from The Lion King. That was the German Shepherd. We had 117 people interested. I never thought that we would have that much interest. We had 37 applications put in. And it didn't go to like one of my friends. It went to people that we felt were the best. We looked for fenced in yards. We wanted you to own your own home because we didn't want Nala sitting in her crate because the people decided to have a baby, and they had a baby, and then Nala sat in a crate after that. So she was only 3 years old, and now she will never be in a crate again. And she is with a new couple. They don't have kids. One is retired, so somebody will always be home with her. And she's a real love. I had the opportunity to meet her, and so she is now at her forever home. We thought we had two more German Shepherds that needed homes, but before I could even post about them, they have both been adopted. They were brother-sister. There is another German Shepherd named Sadie, who is also a three-year-old female, and the human mom lost her home. She is now staying with relatives but cannot have Sadie there, so she's in a kennel right now. She's not ready to give her up yet because she loves her. Talking to her yesterday, she was crying about it, and I said, you know, you have to do what's best for that puppy, because let's face it, it's not a buyer's market for getting homes or even rentals right now. And a dog is a big responsibility and needs a big yard. Some people think, you know, we wound up getting Scooby, the German Shepherd pup that came from Brooklyn. Those people love that dog, but they put the dog ahead of themselves, saying, you know, all right, maybe we didn't make the best decision. We're living in Brooklyn in an apartment and or a house, but they don't have a big yard. And he needed a lot of room and a lot of love. Not that they gave him a lot of love, but I think that he needed a lot of space to run, and they said, we want him to be at the Funny Farm. So Scooby came here. So that person is, you know, trying to decide what she wants to do. She may give her up, but we're thinking maybe somebody can foster her and then maybe make it a forever home. I can tell you right now, I don't do well with fosters. If they're here for more than a couple days, I can't let them go. So people don't understand, why are these dogs at the Funny Farm not available for adoption? The reason is I can't stand it. They become my family after a couple of days and then it's too late. So if I get, that's why Nala never actually came here. She stayed at a friend's house who's better at fostering than I am. And we took her to meet the prospective homes. And she did go to four different homes to see who would do best. It's not like we chose one and just went there. We actually visited with Nala to see who would get the best interaction. And, you know, one house, they had a dog and Nala actually chased their dog. And then we went to another house and then that dog kind of growled at Nala. And then the next two homes were the two best. And we finally picked one of them that we felt
was
the best.
Hannah says she can foster Sadie if you need a foster.
That would be wonderful. If you can, what's her name, Heather?
No. It is Hannah Condi Rodriguez.
Hannah, if you can email me at lori@funnyfarmrescue.org, that would be great. And we can get her because she's coming out of her kennel and the woman's not sure what she's going to do. And like I said, she started to cry. But I don't know how you could foster. I didn't really know if I wanted to get into that. But because of this dog, I just really feel that we need to help out. And like I said, we may be able to get her, have the owner say, yes, it's more important for the dog to go to a forever home. She's sleeping, but she's peeping. Can you hear a little peep?
Yeah. Susan Sheldon wants you to do a book signing in the UK.
I would love to do a book signing in the UK. We might be able to arrange that. So let's, I have to get some helpers here at the farm while I'm gone, but we can probably arrange that. So don't, you know, you never know. The book is international. As far as I know, it's being released in French right now. Well, it's already in English, so we can go to the UK.
Maybe at her house.
At your house. That would be great. So we talked about Pinky the emu, Tommy the turkey, the book, Nala. We talked about fostering Sadie. Trivia night.
Wait, how is Adele doing with all of the new people in the house?
Adele's actually doing okay. She doesn't, I don't even, she's around here somewhere.
I don't know where
Do you
she
see
went.
Her? Uh-uh. Adele. She's here. And Nikki went, hello, Adele. Adele is here and she does fine. She actually, as long as the birds aren't walking around and eating her food, she does okay. Do you see her? Matt's looking.
Oh, yeah. She's eating.
Okay, go ahead. So Matt's going to show Adele.
She's eating Adele. She's eating Nikki's food.
She's eating Nikki's food. She has her head in the bag?
Yeah. She got her diaper on.
So there's Adele. She has her diaper on. We gave her butt a break for a little while from the diaper. As you can see, I don't have any carpets. A lot of you have seen my inside of my house, and it actually looks pretty clean today, believe it or not. There's no rugs, because as soon as there's rugs, there's poop or pee on them. So I have hardwoods. It actually smells nice in here. I do have a cleaning person. My girl comes every week. She's wonderful, and cleans my house and like scrubs the floors, makes it smell nice. Nikki, really? You have something to say?
She just found out that.
So Nikki is an 8-year-old cockatoo. Yeah, she found out that she's mad.
Adele's eating your food.
She's the 8-year-old cockatoo. For those who don't know about cockatoos, they live to be 80 or 90 years old. So if you get them, you have to will them to someone. And they become a one-person bird. She is mostly friendly, but she does bite me once in a while. You guys saw the Christmas special, maybe. If you didn't, you can go back on YouTube. I was reading an Adele book that Matt wrote, and she was sitting on my shoulder right here, being very sweet. And when I went to go put her back, she did not want to get off and wanted me to read her another book and bit me on the shoulder. I was not very happy with her. She was a bad girl. She was in timeout for a little bit.
She doesn't remember that.
She doesn't remember. So trivia night.
Oh yeah, trivia.
We didn't really know that we had trivia night. That's our COVID trivia night. So we usually have Funny Farm people that watch us not volunteer. They buy tickets for $10 for the whole family, and they can participate in trivia with Nor'easter Nick and a lot of us from the Funny Farm. Obviously, I'll be on with whatever critters. Matt usually is on. Marina, Kim. A bunch of our volunteers usually participate, and then visitors as well. We're doing it. It's a little bit different format. We're doing it with all Expiro's nonprofits, and we will get 90% of the proceeds for the Funny Farm. You know, each group will get their proceeds 90%. So we're not sure how this one's going to be, but I think there's going to be a lot more people. So it might be pretty exciting. So 7:00 Thursday night. We don't even have the link up, right, Matt? You have to do the link.
Right.
After the live, we'll post it.
Susan Sheldon said that she can host you to do a book signing at her house.
Cool. So Susan.
and Debbie Carr wants you to do a book signing in Idaho.
In Idaho. Okay, we're going to try and do a book signing at both those places. Susan, what town are you in?
She wants to know what your favorite refreshments are so she can make you dinner.
My favorite refreshments. Wow. I like a parrot head. Do you guys know what that is? I don't drink often because if I drink, I fall asleep, and then there's no help in these animals. But some days I want to come, you know, after a long day, I'm like, I'm ready to drink. So not only do we have the baby emu here, for those who are just tuning in, I'm going to go through this again. She is a four-month-old baby emu. You can see her feathers are shedding. What do you got to say, pretty girl? She has tape, electrical tape, not electrical tape, duct tape. Duct tape fixes everything. Duct tape just doesn't fix ducks. It fixes emus, too. Is it right? Duct tape? It's
duct
D-U-C-T.
Tape solves every problem.
Anyway, we had her with pink duct tape. You could kind of see underneath. We had to change her dressing, and we didn't have time to do it back to pink. But it was hot pink, so we named her Pinky. And she has to have her legs hobbled because sometimes it's a niacin deficiency, but sometimes when they're babies, one of the adults can step on her, or she could slip on a slippery surface and her leg goes out and it's kind of like sprained, and that's what happens. So she can't stand up. She does stand up now. Come on, girlfriend, show them. See how she's kind of standing up here? Oh, she's biting the couch.
Well, she's a little crooked.
Well, she's crooked because my butt is sinking her in and it's making her unsteady. But that's why her, hold on there, ma'am.
But if you didn't have that tape on, her legs are like straight out both sides.
Her leg would be like ice skating, like a split almost. So this, she has to, she can still walk around. She does flip over on her side in her pen sometimes, so we have to keep a constant eye. And I can go show you her pen because I have to show somebody else here.
Okay.
So, all right, so let's go show her. So you want to meet Nikki? Nikki! Oh, look at Nikki. Yeah, can you see her with that light or is that?
Yeah, I see.
What's that? Is that hi, say hi to the emu. She's a baby. Oh my goodness, she got all excited. Nick, who's that?
Better be nice to her. She's
be nice. You be nice, Nikki. Okay, we won't get them too close, but it's like nice to show. Nikki's not sure.
Debbie Carr wants to know if Pinky's going to live in the house forever.
Debbie Carr, I hope not, because that's going to be some big poops. I think that this one... Watch, she likes this.
Wee! 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 She does like that. She does like that. You can make a diaper for the emu, right?
Oh, sure. We can make a diaper. So I have two birds in here now. Actually, three birds. What am I saying? Four birds. I have the turkey. I have Adele. Are you biting my... Look, they like shiny things, as you can see. Mm-hmm. She likes my feather necklace.
Ooh, Adele's not going to like that.
Right, Adele? Adele. Oh, not Adele. Right, Nikki?
Adele likes... She's in charge of all this.
What? Okay, should we go back? Are you ready to go back to bed?
Everybody wants to know how my trip was and my mom.
Okay, go ahead.
All right.
Here, you want me to show?
No, she's good. It was fun.
We can show you for a minute. Ready? I'll try it. Let's see.
No, you can't do it.
Let go. Just let it go. No.
Lori, okay.
Look, oh, boy.
Oh, now it's up.
I got it. So go ahead, Matt. Tell us about your trip.
Well, my trip is really good. What else? My mom's good. We call her Granny. She's doing great. First went to Florida to see the Blue Angels. That was fun with
them. Okay. Whoa.
Oh, yeah. You're really
there
good.
We go. I got it back, Matt. It's working. The magic hands, they have to touch it.
So first went to Florida to see the Blue Angels at the Sun and Fun air show. I don't know if everyone knows, Lori and I are both pilots. That's one reason how we met. And
Wait. Matt always says, and then I built my own plane.
Yeah, she bought a little Cessna, which, you know, anyone could buy. But I built my own plane.
Sue Snyder says, hi, Matt. All right, we're getting tired of you, Matt, so finish it up.
And then I went up to New York and had fun with my family for a few days, and then Lori had to go on a business trip, so I came back early.
Yep. That's it. Okay. Bye-bye, Matt.
Hey, that's still not nice.
So, yeah, poor Matt had to... Oh. I was working. You broke it. So, poor Matt got to go see his family. I do really appreciate it, Matt. He, ow! She went to get... She went... That wasn't funny! That was not nice!
I thought it was funny, too.
So, she went to get my... She went to get my necklace and actually pinched me a little bit. Silly girl. But I...
She's laughing.
Not nice. So Matt went home to see his family, and he hasn't seen his mom in a year because she's in a nursing home. But she's in the assisted living, right, Matt? Because she comes out.
Yeah, so she can come out for... She wanted to go to Walmart.
So Matt had to take her to Walmart. So Matt did that, and then I found out, you know, I'm fully vaccinated, as well as most of our volunteers. Matt is as well. And so I had to go to my I have a Washington, D.C. job, which I would go once a month usually. So I wound up having to take the train down there and do that. And I was going to be gone so long because it's a 3-hour trip. So I said, Matt, I need you to come back and babysit. He knows how to do everything. So he came and helped me. But he flew home so he can fly back quick. So he's going to go back and forth quick with his airplane.
Yeah, and, it's about an hour.
Yeah.
Better than 8 hours driving.
8-hour drive equals an hour in his plane back and forth. So, all right, okay. What are you trying to say? What? Okay, we'll go. We're going to, let's go see where she lives. So,
okay.
Bye-bye, Nick. We'll go one more ride. Ready?
Debbie Carr's brother-in-law is a pilot.
Awesome.
He and my sister had a flight business in Anchorage for years.
Wow, that's
that would
awesome.
Be fun.
So it is not my business. It is not Matt's business. We fly completely for fun.
Wait a minute,
fun.
I'm a commercial pilot.
Well, you're a commercial pilot, but do you do it for commercial? No, you
no.
don't. We do pilots and paws. We used to, we've rescued some animals by plane. However, there's so many animals in New Jersey to rescue. We've been kind of concentrating on what's been going on here. But when there's a real crisis, we actually will help out, fly down and pick them up and bring them home. Get them. Not all stay here, hopefully.
Does
Are we
Matt
done?
Fly himself, yes.
Matt flies himself. He always needs assistance though, with whatever he does.
Unless Lori's flying and then she goes upside down. Which is not fun.
All right, are you done? Look, she really could do this all day. The whole live, right? So I just wanna swing.
She flies like she drives.
Okay, ready? Let's go see. Here's
Aunt
one
Sue,
of the
Aunt Sue said she flies too. But she flies a broom.
And she flies a broom. So this is Darth Vader. This is That's the one right. kitty. You can see this is her, one of her houses that were donated. And this is Darth Vader. She has polyps. So when she breathes, she goes, it's hard for her. But the vets have all looked at her.
She's not sick.
She's not sick. She's been on every kind of antibiotic. We thought we just couldn't get her better. And it turned out that she has some polyps. So we're seeing as she grows what's happening. And we may have to do a surgery there for her. Okay, so this is where, this is my kitchen. Where else would your emu live, right? So this is her. You gonna show?
Uh-huh.
All right, girlfriend. Here we go. Ready? Sit up. So this is her little bed, and you can see she kind of matches the bed. She's like camouflaged. She eats mealworms, and then she eats some crumbles, and it's starter crumbles for chicks. Mealworms are high in protein. They need a certain amount of protein. And then I have some, a little bit of Nikki food in there because it's, you know, they like to eat little rocks and things like that. So it's a mixture of food. Oh, there she goes.
So Susan Sheldon said that... I am a good man, and that you're lucky to know me.
Yes. All right. Let's. I. You know what? I agree 100%. I just don't like to admit it.
She said that I'm a fooder, but that's so not true.
You know what? It would be okay if he wasn't like, yeah, well, I do this. You know, it's one of those people. If you're cool and you're good, we know it. We don't have to have you brag about it, Matt.
I never said that.
But no, I do appreciate Matt as a huge helper, as well as all my other volunteers. Without volunteers, all these animals would be in trouble because we have way too many. And I, again, National Appreciation Volunteer Week is
so
going to be extended.
Who needs a kitchen table anyway, right?
Who needs a kitchen table, right?
So this is your kitchen table, right?
This is my kitchen table, obviously. And then, of course, you could see I have blankets, donations up. The dogs knocked that one off. Puppy chair. You know, it's my...
And Tucker out the door.
Oh, here comes Adele walking around. And then these are the two Bailey chairs that... This is the one Bailey chair that my friend Steve Anderson made. This one is a car seat with a blanket over top because the cats decided to get in there and pee-pee. So we had to take out... That so we just get new blankets every so often. So sit up and eat, and then Tucker will sit in his birthday. Tucker was 3 years old yesterday. Should we bring him in?
Yeah, so
we might as well.
Vicky and Tree are both watching.
Oh, hey Vicky, hey Tree. Vicky and Tree helped me hobble and put the brace on the emu and the turkey we did, but she reviewed my work and said, good job.
So people, she did help you with a little brace, right?
She did. Vicky and Tree both. So Vicky works at a hospital, and so does Tree. Tree is an RN. We always joke and say Vicky's our vet tech, but she's not really. So but she probably knows more than a vet tech. Vicky is a pulmonary. Shoot. Pulmonary.
She's a
therapist.
Yeah.
I got it.
She's an animal what tech.
We always say, did you just hear me? I just said that.
Vet tech.
We said she's like a vet tech, but she knows more than a vet tech usually. But she and Tree, the nurse and the pulmonary, what are they saying? Are they saying stuff back?
Yeah. Susan Sheldon, I can't believe it, not saying another word. Mind you, Laura usually reads these comments, doesn't she? Yes, she does read these
comments.
Matt
reads them at first, and that's why his head's too big, and then sometimes he can't fit into the kitchen because he can't get
it. I get in trouble later.
So the dogs are very upset, so we'll bring them in.
People are saying that it's freezing, and that's because of the stormy weather. We have a rainy storm.
But they can hear me okay. Sorry, yeah. It's not the best weather outside. It's not raining here, but... It is. Excuse you. We're not going to fight in here or else. All right, Brooke, come on. Let's go outside, Brooke. Come on. Brookie, come on. Let's go out.
Tucker,
come on, good girl.
Mama? Tucker, where's your mama?
So maybe we should put Tucker in his chair.
Oh, we have something to say about Tucker.
I just... All right, you guys all said Tucker turned 3 yesterday, right? Only Matt didn't hear that. Tucker had a 3-year-old birthday, which is amazing since he has mega esophagus. Most of you know his condition. It's when his... esophagus is enlarged, and he was born like that, and it's a moving muscle, so it is not operable. He needs to sit up in his chair. Let's see if he'll do it. Ask Tucker, you want to sit up? He's like, I don't see any food. Tucker, get in. He's like, let me fake him out. Hang on, maybe I'll give him just a little bit of milk.
Tucker, you gotta get in the
come
chair.
On get in your chair. Come on, look, I got some right there. Come on, get in. So back it up, Matt, so they can see. He's going to back in, and he'll sit up. Good boy. And then we have the little hook to hold it in. This is new for me because I used to have to hold his bowl the entire time. Now, mommy can do hands-free. It's like talking on the phone. So I can just put it down, and I can concentrate on holding Jesse up because he can't fit into a Bailey chair yet. So that is very helpful. He eats a can and a half or two cans of food every 3 hours. Come here, Hopey Hope.
We never get to see her.
This is Hope. Yep. See, her one eye is bad. I don't know if you guys remember the Hope and Jell-O story. This was the kitten that was found on the side of the road with his mom. The mom laid there dead. And Hope was crying next to the mom going, how come you're not feeding me? Because once, you know, the mom dies, she's not producing milk anymore. And a passerby found her and brought her here. Well, kept trying to get in touch with me, and it was Memorial Day or Labor Day, one of those. Memorial Day?
It was Memorial Day.
Memorial Day. Yeah. And I was like, oh, this phone doesn't stop ringing. So after a bunch of phone calls, I finally answered and met the guy at the farm. He brought Hope, and I thought she was going to die. She looked completely blind. Both eyes were a mess. And every few minutes, I sat up with her, giving her a couple droplets of food, and she made it through the night. She was just a little tiny thing. You want more? So we named her Hope because I was hoping she was going to make it every few minutes. All right, I'm giving this
Nancy,
is KMR.
Happy birthday, Tucker. Isn't he your second dog with Mega?
Yes,
esophagus?
Tucker is my second dog with Mega Esophagus. The first dog I had was Chucky. He had the worst case of Mega Esophagus ever. The University of Penn said he's not going to make 6 months without a chair. There's no surgery that can work. And then he had other issues besides, so it wasn't just Mega Esophagus. And he wound up making it 5 years and a month, and they called him the miracle dog. So this is KMR. This is actually kitten food. It's liquid. This is one of the things on our wish list. Very, very important for kittens, which we're going to show you in 1 minute.
Kittens? We have kittens?
We have a couple kittens. Yes, we do. So I'm going to give a little bit of a... I'm giving a little bit to Tucker. Don't tell the kittens.
Don't give that to Tucker. He's going to grow whiskers.
So it's like it won't hurt him. I don't feed him much. I just don't have his. So his food is blended up puppy chow, pedigree puppy chow, mixed with this blender.
They want to know what happened to Jesse.
Jesse's outside. Jesse might be asleep. Let me look.
The ninja blender.
Oh, Jesse's right here.
Which has tape on it because it has a crack.
Jesse, come here. Hurry up, Jess. Jess, come on. Hurry. All right, here comes Jesse. Let's see. He's going to probably jump in his chair too.
Hi, Jesse.
Jesse, come on, we'll act like we should have had food ready. Here, Jesse. Jesse, come on, get in your chair. I need more luck. So he'll sit in his chair, and
he needs a big one now.
He's getting bigger, but he still is too, excuse me, 1 second. He is still too big, too small for that big chair. So, and Steve is in the middle of making a second one. Okay, we'll do one more. Ready? Hang on. Puppy, you're not helping. Get off. So this is what happens. Oh, you're splashing. He's a little bit of a messy eater, but you can see he sits up. He knows he has to sit up. If not, he regurgitates his food. Because he's a puppy, he is eternally hungry. He will sometimes eat Adele's food, and then all of a sudden he'll start going... And then you know it's coming. And it's not really throw up because it's not coming from his stomach, but it gets caught in his chest up here. And then it will come out, and then he usually tries to eat it again. And so we have to take it away from him afterwards to make sure that he doesn't. Hold on there, Jess, hold on.
So people are asking if you need more KMR.
Yes, so we always need KMR. We actually need another blender, but we're gonna have to put this out because it's a specific one. You can see.
It says professional on the bottom,
professional,
right?
But that's what it looks like, Ninja Professional, but there's a bunch of different brands and I haven't been able to find it. I'm gonna have to look online, but we broke the pitcher. It gets a lot of wear and tear. It blends their food, about three cans every 3 hours forever.
Six or seven to eight
times a day.
It works
so
hard.
It is a hard-working machine. We have tried every type of blender and...
Do we want powder KMR or just liquid?
No powder if you can help it. We have enough, we have powder, but it tends to give the kitties...
The runs.
Diarrhea. Sorry, diarrhea, yeah. So now they're supposed to sit up here for 10 minutes. And then, so Tucker, it's easy because he will just stay there. Jesse, we didn't feed him that much, so we'll just keep him up here for a minute. But Jesse is about 4 months old now, I believe.
Yeah.
And he is a black lab and part tick hound. What, Tucker? And
hi, Jesse.
The owners got him at Christmas and found out usually it's interbreeding that causes this defect in their chest. And we wound up getting him. They only had him for a week or two, and it was hard for them, but they knew that they were not able to care for them. It is more work, but I have a couple friends that have mega esophagus dogs, and they're doing great with their dogs. Every dog's a little different. Some of them you can make little meatballs and not make it so liquidy, but everything that we've ever tried, I go right back to the same food that I have, making it very, very much like liquid, like a doggy milkshake. Some dogs don't have it as bad, and you can develop it later in life. All of the dogs that I ever had with it have been born with it.
They're wondering about Scooby-Doo.
Scooby-Doo. We'll get Scooby in here. All right, Tucker, are you ready to come out? It's not 10 minutes, but I think you'll be fine. Because it wasn't that much food, and it was very liquidy. Scoob! He's sound asleep. Do you want to go out and see him?
Yeah.
Scooby! Hi, guys! There's Scooby. You can see it was muddy and out, and he is definitely a mud dog. He wants to see usually what's in. Usually he comes up and licks the bowl when he's done. When I close this, he'll get up on the stool. Watch, if I put the stool here.
This is so funny.
Let's see, watch. He'll jump up and, oh, look at, Jesse's like, we're done? Are you kidding me? Jesse's like, so you can tell whenever they're hungry, this is what happens. I don't even have to say get in. He just gets, honey, I'll feed you when we're done the live, okay? When we're done, all right?
He wants the whole man.
Okay, that's what we'll do. All right. Because we have kittens to show, right?
What?
Yep. We do have kittens right now. A lot of them have been spoken for. If you're interested, we get more all the time. But a lot of these, I think the three I'm going to show you are spoken for. Some of the others are a little too young.
You need to do a reality show.
No, we don't need to do a reality show. Believe it or not, somebody asked me to do a reality show in from Florida. And I just said, I have enough drama in my life. Could you imagine? You know, the reality shows add more. What could be added? We don't need any more drama. We're good here. And I have a full-time job and then the farm, which is another full-time job. So I don't really need anything more.
Christina, we were there Tuesday and me and my kids had the best time. Thank you for everything you do.
Oh, I'm so glad. A lot of you, I have been meeting you as you're coming. You say, we watched the live and we're so happy to be here. So we're happy that you guys all decided to come and visit. So come on in, Matt. So these three, oh wait, my bottle. Let me get my bottle. Hold on. The dogs all want to see. Oh, this one's climbing. So they're a little hungry. I've been trying to teach them to start eating out of their bowl. So if you see, if you ever have a kitten and you're in dire need and you have to take care of it yourself, don't ever flip them upside down. You're not helping me, honey. You don't ever flip them this way. It will go into their lungs and they can drown from that. So,
Lori, what's your full-time job?
My full-time job, I work at the FAA. I own my own graphic design and photography business. So that is my full-time job. And I have a contract with the FAA and one with Selective Service System in Roslyn, near the Arlington Cemetery out there in D.C. So you can see, they have KMR heated up. You have to test it just like you would a regular baby bottle on your wrist. And then I give it a little squirt to help them. And then they usually figure it out on their own and they suck it on it and then get the milk themselves. They get a little crazy trying to get the milk they want. It. Mickey, shush, shush.
Where do these kittens come from?
These kittens came from under somebody's shed. And I believe that mom, they found the body out, got hit by a car. Uh-oh. So that's why we have these babies.
Nancy Fleish. My son works for Lori.
Nancy! David Hess!
Yeah.
Oh, she has a new last name. I didn't recognize it. Nancy, I've known Nancy for a long, long time. Hi, Nance. David's been with me for, 28, 29 years.
So this is what happens with the chicken perches?
So there are the chicken perches that some of you have donated to me, and they have been stolen from Jesse
and
Scooby. They fight over them like, okay. So they, Nikki, they teeth, and this is a good thing that Jesse can do because it is wood. And even though he gets, he gets probably a little bit in him, it's not like he's chewing a bone and eating snacks. Okay, you're done? Let's see.
And earlier talked about Chucky. That's Chucky.
That's Chucky, the megasophagus boy.
He was awesome.
And we have a book and a movie out with about Chucky because he was so,
let's see,
inspirational. So this is another one you can see. They want the bottle every couple hours too. So that's why it's hard to catch up here at the Funny Farm because every few hours everybody needs something. Or every few minutes if it's Matt. Matt, what do you need now?
It's more like, Matt, I need this.
Matt, I always go, Matt, could you get me a bottle? Because when I run out of this one, I have another one. But if it gets too cool, they can't have it.
Yep.
So I'm like, Matt, could you heat this up for 10 seconds for me? So Jesse is not sure if he wants to play with his little rubber thing or if he wants to play with them together or the
So John wants perch. To know which one was Nyla. So Nyla was a dog.
Nyla, I'm sorry, was a German Shepherd. I said Nyla, that's what we got the information. It was really Nala, N-A-L-A, like the Lion King. So Nala was the one German Shepherd. We didn't have her here. She came from Maryland. People had a baby, and she was basically living in a crate after that.
There's Tucker.
But you can see Hope is trying to play with the kittens.
Hi, Tucker.
Tucker, you want to hear? We'll have you clean a baby. Don't help out too much, Scoob. Scooby, not too much. All right, you guys. Tucker knows, but the little puppies aren't not sure yet. We're training them slowly. Easy. So they sometimes help. You want to help wash the butt? Here. Help wash the butt. All right, good boy. Help wash the butt.
Yo.
So I didn't finish telling you that these baby kittens, they're so young. Normally, they can't go to the potty on their own. So the mommy usually licks their butt and makes them go. So you can take, sorry, I'm not doing that. So I usually take a paper towel and I just pat it and then you'll feel that it gets warm and that's them going to the potty. So not only can they not eat on their own, they can't go to the potty on their own. So Tucker, so I usually get some help. All the dogs know to help me. We'll get this one. No, we gotta get the third one. This is the little girl here. She's a muted calico. Again, these are already spoken for once they're old enough to go. We do have four more. I guess I could go show them. They're black and white, and all black. And then I think we took in three more. Are you helping? You helping while she's eating? You do the back end, I got the front end. All right, we're tag teaming.
Jesse.
Matt's like, Rose.
He kisses me with that mouth.
Yeah, always think of that, you guys, when you're getting kissed by the animals here. They not only do they eat poop sometimes, they help clean the other animals. Not to be gross, but you know. There we go. So if you do have a kitten, keep them like they would suck on their mom. They kind of lay flat. Do not ever push them backwards. Have it the KMR be temperature like you would feel on like you would a baby bottle, warm so it doesn't burn you on your wrist.
Uh-oh, someone's trying to escape.
Oh yeah, we have escapees and these were donated by all of you. This is one of the kitten tents that we have.
We call them kitty hotels.
Kitty hotels we call them. And you know, I have to do all their beds and stuff, so we were just putting them in here. They are actually getting introduced to the litter box today, and hopefully they will start going. You put a cat in and you scratch their front feet, and they usually can figure that out at a pretty young age. So we're going to try that today, and I'm also going to, they have teeth, we're going to introduce a little bit of food in a bowl. Not a bowl, a flat bowl. Uh-oh, what happened? All right, so he's got it. He's taking it. He stole it. Look,
bye.
Scooby, where'd you go?
He went down.
He stole it.
He drops it. It's finders keepers.
Justin's so this is our 54th episode. 54. We are watching the Funny Farm Rescue and Sanctuary. We are located in Mays Landing, New Jersey. We are open Tuesdays and Sundays from 8 to 4. No matter what, all year long, people were calling me all day. It's raining. Are you still open? We are open. If it's a hailstorm, we're open. I live here, so the animals have to be taken care of. So I figured, what the heck? We'll just open the gate, and if somebody can get here, we're here. So you don't have to be. He's stretching. He's doing his yoga.
Jesse,
you doing your yoga? You can see the animals have free reign of the house, whatever they want to do.
I can't still over.
All right, buddy.
There we go.
He's still sitting there. Are you stretching? Are you stuck? He's like, I'm doing a wheelbarrow. Nobody's helping me with my beer. And he goes, I'm so tall that I can just step down.
He just spills.
And then there's Tucker.
So they want to know about your boots.
Oh, my boots. So I didn't have exactly green to match my shirt, but they're tealy green. So I figured that close enough, right? And I do have matching socks because they're brand new. Somebody gave them to me for Patty's Day, and they have some green on them, green and white. Normally, I take off my boots, and they are not matching socks because Brookie steals them all. For Christmas, I got a bunch of socks, so I actually didn't even take them apart yet, and I actually have matching socks once in a while now. Who
for
is
like
yelling?
At least an hour.
At least for an hour until I take them off, and then Brookie steals them, no matter what I do. Hello.
Oh, you like the kitties, huh?
You want to see the kitties? So, if anybody has a dog and cats and they're trying to figure out how to acclimate, no. So you saw Jesse just barked at them. I say no. And then I slowly will either hold a big cat, little cat, and you work them together and you say, do nice. Come here, Jesse. So same with the turkey. We teach them you're not allowed to eat your brothers and sisters.
Uh-oh. Jesse just found out that Scooby stole it.
Uh-oh. He might bark. he's barking at him. He's mad. So they are 1 week apart. Scooby and Jesse are 1 week apart in age. So they are the best of friends because they're so close in age. So it's wonderful. They don't have to be close in age. Even if I didn't have the two of them, they would play with Puppy or Tucker or Brooke. You know, they figure out Farley's kind of like the grumpy old man. He doesn't really want to hang out with the kids, but I will catch him playing on occasion with them. So, any other questions? We are...
All right, there is a question.
What's that?
From Judy Barsuglia.
Okay.
It says, good morning. I was wondering if I come to the farm, can I sign up to get your book? Get the new book and the movie.
Probably
the Chucky movie, I think.
The Chucky movie. The Chucky movie is different than my book right now. But yes, you can sign up. You can even send us an email. We just won't be able to have the book until September 7th, until the publisher sends it to us. So the publisher are the ones that are, getting them printed and doing the marketing and all that kind of stuff. So whatever they say, that's what I have to do. And they tell me it'll be available to me on September 7th.
So Linda Hansen. Hello, Lori and Matt. Happy to see you again and the animals.
Hi, Linda Hansen in Washington.
I'm Linda from Washington.
Not Washington, D.C., Washington State.
Yeah, you.
Which we know where that is.
Have new animals. Love them. Happy birthday. Tucker, 3 years old.
Tucker, we're happy. Thank you, Linda. Yes, I just had volunteers from like a month ago that haven't been here in a month, and they're like, you have more animals now. I'm like, go figure.
They want to see the cat on the piano.
Oh, the cat on the piano, that's Steve. That piano, so when my mom passed away, I didn't have much because we rented. She didn't have any money. Somebody gave her this piano. I think in my book it says we purchased it for a little bit, but I don't think she gave any money for it. And it was ugly and white, and my mom and all the kids, we stripped it down. And it was from 1906 or 1909, this piano. And it was a player piano, but my mom knew how to play guitar chords on her left hand and the melody on her right. And she tried to teach all the kids, and I'm the only one who picked it up. So I got my mom's piano. And I do play. Sometimes Nikki is quiet when I play the piano. Right, Nick? But you can see Buddy's cage is back here.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about
Buddy. So show Buddy's cage. So when Buddy comes back, we're going to have to move the kittens. I need a bigger house is what this comes down to. So I can't play the piano since Buddy has been laid up in here. So he doesn't stay in here all the time, but he has to go in there to eat, and we have to make sure none of the other animals jump on him like that toddler did to
so
make sure he doesn't get hurt.
I have 10 dogs, but none of them jumped on Buddy. But
I have exactly. I have 10 dogs. All of them were able to be. They all knew to respect Buddy's leg and not hurt him, but we had somebody's little toddler kid jump on him. So thank goodness nothing is broken, but unfortunately he does have to have another surgery. They're not sure if that toddler added to it. It was just such a coincidence that the toddler fell on him and then he couldn't walk. So I think he helped injure it, even if the pin was back.
Barbara Long wants to know, Lori, what can't you do?
Barbara Long, you are so sweet. I can't cook, Barbara. I am a stinky, stinky cook. Well, I'm a baker. I don't have an oven at the moment, but I can bake cookies. Everybody said, if you ever lose your job, you can do chocolate. I only do chocolate chip cookies. I have a secret recipe, and I am getting a stove soon. Right now, it's used for storage inside, but I am not a good cook, so that's something I cannot do.
Your Uncle Woe played the piano, and so does your cousin Louie.
Yep. My cousin Louie plays the piano, and so we are mechanically, musically inclined. The McNulty's, that's my mom's side, and my uncle. I used to call him Uncle Wo-Wo, Uncle Edward, but I guess I couldn't say Edward, so I called him Wo. That was Sue's husband, my uncle, and that's Aunt Sue. That's who she was married to. She is now with Kramer, who we love. But Uncle Wo-Wo was very musically inclined. I think he can play way more than the piano.
So Sandy Hill says people need to watch their children when they are at the Funny Friday.
Yes. So most of the people are very good about their kids. I won't think twice about yelling at somebody who says, hey, you can't do that. You're going to hurt the animals. Also, you just don't, even if the dog is healthy, you don't want your kids falling on them, because if the dog gets too startled, God knows if they would maybe bite them or whatever. So, but Buddy's leg, you could see that it was, am I interrupting your playtime? Are you showing them? Can you see?
Yeah, you can see.
I think that we're, Nikki, tell them.
So, Jesse doesn't have any ribs showing. He looks great.
Both of them. I think Tucker looks good too.
I think this
little guy, because he is a puppy, is eating more. Ow, that's my finger. That's my finger.
Scooby's looking at the kittens.
He's making sure that everybody's good in there. He's like, are you going to start feeding? Oh, and Hope is inside with them.
Aw.
They think that that's the mom.
That's nice.
Hopey Hope, you're such a good girl.
He's taking care of her. He wants to make sure that it don't.
But yes, Scooby is not sure about any of all of these animals that are here. He's getting used to them. He's going to be a big, gigantic German Shepherd. I'm afraid he's going to wag his tail and then my whole coffee table is going to go flying. When he's bigger, he's only about 4 months old. And
he's big already.
He's a big boy. When he walks through the house, it sounds like a little bear, like goo, 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 goo. I can always tell that it's him, right? This one's like tippy toes, like twinkle toes through the house. He's got the long legs, and he's skinny, but filled out enough for his breed is not as heavy as.
Jesse's like a little love muffin, you know?
Jesse is like a little praying mantis with his long legs.
He always wants to hug and cuddle.
Right, good boy. Oh, he's trying to bite me right now.
He's the sensitive one.
Yes. So.
Where's Nemo?
Nemo. Nemo, I have something to tell you about Nemo. He ate $1,000 check. So did you guys all see? I always say, none of the animals leave the funny farm. Well, we had two horses. One of the volunteers left one of the gates open in the back. And Anna, our naughty racehorse, said, I haven't run in a long time, like really far. So she took her boyfriend Canyon with the one eye. And they leave. And they went across Route 40, which is a very busy highway. I mean, it's a one laner each way. But it's busy. It goes from here. I think it goes all the way to California, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe I'm wrong, because you know me in geography. But I know it's a very, very long road. I take that when I go to Washington. I take the train from Wilmington. So I take Route 40 all the way. They ran across Route 40, and one of the guys that live in the area knows the funny farm. He drives a tractor trailer, Mike Nelson, and he saw the horse run out. So he started to go again, and then here comes Canyon taken up from behind, the one eye, and he can't even see on this side, so he wasn't looking both ways before he ran across the road. So thank goodness nobody hit him, and they went over to see another horse across the way. So my nice neighbor came and helped me walk them home, and while I was gone, my little niece put the had already put Nemo to bed in the bird cage, and I said, "Don't tie it too tight, because then I can't get it open." Well, oh, somebody's sneaking up on the couch. Oh, he's trying. He's like, "This turkey's in my way, but I'm gonna do it." Go ahead, you're almost there. He's giving up. And so she didn't tie it tight enough. So when I got home, I was going through some of the checks, and she ate all the checks. So I know of the $1,000 one because that was what I was working on when I left, and there were two others. So I'm not even sure who they were from. So if anybody gave me a check and I didn't deposit it, it's because Nemo ate it. I didn't even call the lady with the $1,000 check yet. I'm too like embarrassed. It happened before.
But you know who she is, right?
So yes, I do know
who she is. Nemo lives outside now.
So Nemo is now, yeah, so all that long story, I know. Matt's got to keep me on track. So he lives out on the porch now. However, the other night it got so cold, I broke down and let him back in. But I made sure I was home the whole time.
Tucker, what are you doing?
They're playing. So you can see, even though Tucker's not a puppy, he's three, he has a great time playing with them. They play all the time, and he knows not to hurt them. Nikki's laughing.
Tucker plays nice.
Watch the candle. Oh, boy.
Yeah, watch the candle.
So the candles, everybody always says, don't forget. I have to always burn my candles. I love Yankee candles, any kind of candle, but they smell really, really good. So I usually have
Teresa,
a bunch of these.
You guys make my Sunday. I look forward to it all week.
That is so sweet. Thank you guys all for tuning in. Again, we are the Funny Farm Rescue and Sanctuary located in Mays Landing, New Jersey. If you want to volunteer, you can come any Tuesday, any Sunday. No appointment required. The only thing we ask for you is to sign a waiver online at funnyfarmrescue.org. What, Matt? I can see you laughing.
Christine says, Lori, it's See, you have to pick up the checks and lock them in a cabinet someplace.
You know, Christine, I actually, Christine, I do really do that. This was an emergency. And he was away, so I thought all the dogs were getting in the truck to come anyway. So not all 10, one or two were outside, but the other eight were in the truck. So Matt actually drove me down, dropped me off, and I walked them home. But I usually do. I learned my lesson a while ago when Nemo ate some other checks, so I always locked them up. But I didn't have time because it was so important for me to go get the horses that ran across the highway. I was more concerned with that. So I know, Polish and blonde, it's a double whammy.
Dana wants to see the orange kitten again, and she wants to know if it's up for adoption.
They are not up for adoption. These have already been spoken for. But wait, watch them for a second. I'll get the ones that are up. Possibly one, two might be up for adoption. Hold on.
They're like, hey, where'd they go? Where'd they go? I don't know.
Hello.
Hello. Hi, Scooby. Where's your mama? Where'd your mama go?
Hello. Come on, Scrap. Come on. Jesse, come.
Hello.
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 Hello. Yeah, pretty girl.
Okay, so some of these are going to be up for adoption. They need a bath. Oh, my goodness. We were trying to introduce them to the litter box already. This is a black one. This is a tigery striped. And then I have two tuxedos. They look like this. So they have to get their bath today again. They are playing with their food all over the place. You want some or not? He's like, okay. So
as soon as you get done feeding and then you give them a bath, you have to feed them again?
Yeah, then I have to feed them again. That's correct. So, all right, one at a time, one at a time. But here's the orange kitty. Unfortunately, he is not adopted. He's already been adopted, he just can't go home yet.
So his name's Matt?
No, his name is not Matt.
Or he's really cute.
They're all kittens are cute, Matt.
This one's extra cute because he has orange hair.
He's a ginger. And you can see how cute they are when they latch onto that bottle. And see the little ears go like little Yoda? Can you see, Matt? Are you showing it?
I'm trying to.
I'll get out of the light.
Okay, I got it.
Look at the little feet going. Oh, so big. So we take in. All right, Nikki likes that. Nikki, we don't need to scream while we're on the live. It's okay. Now she's laughing. So I do Zoom calls for work, and then she decides to act up in the background. It always makes for an interesting Zoom.
And there's Hope watching everybody.
Hope's like, are you our mom? She said, I could be your mom. I just don't have any milk. There you go, babies. You need to eat. Any more questions? Because I think we're at that time. So thanks for watching the Funny Farm Rescue and Sanctuary. We're located at Mays Landing, New Jersey. Don't confuse us with anybody else because we do have some copycats out there.
Yep. Robert Long, one last question. What can I give a stray cat to help him gain weight?
Stray cat, I mean, just feed him. Maybe he's not getting enough food. Wet food can actually put some weight on them easier than the dry food. That would be your best bet. Something, you know, high in protein, a good wet food, and just feed him more often because maybe he's not eating enough. That's what I would say.
Do we take kittens?
So we do take kittens, but you have to call us because we can get overwhelmed very quickly. As you can see, I'm bottle feeding these, all of them, and it's every 3 hours, along with doing the two dogs. And I don't always have help around the clock.
So today's one of those quiet days where you just sit around and do nothing?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I eat my bonbons and watch TV. And everybody talks about television. I'm like, in my next life, that's what I'm going to do. I actually love, people say, oh, I don't like that. I love television. I would love to sit. You know, half my animals are named from TV shows I used to watch, like Laverne and Shirley, 2 and a Half Men, Friends, were my shows, but they're not on anymore. Well, I guess they are on probably reruns, but.
Angie, are you open Tuesdays to come with the kids?
Yes, Tuesdays and Sundays from 8 to 4, year round, no matter what the weather. So if it's raining, you just have the farm to yourselves. You just put some rain gear on and come on out. You can help if you want to volunteer. You can even volunteer same day. If you come and say, hey, you know what? I'd like to volunteer while I'm here. We don't care if it's 1 hour, 5 minutes, you know, 4 hours,
Denise,
whatever.
Holden, my cats and dog are sitting next to me and can hear the kittens and Nikki.
Are they watching?
So funny to see them looking around for them.
You'll have to take a picture and post it for us.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, so that's funny. Buddy, that's how he, when he hurt his foot originally, I guess this one's done. When he hurt his foot originally, he sees the dog on TV. And I know that if he's hearing them, he always does the same thing. We have other people that send us pictures and they sometimes hear Tucker and the dogs and the cats. They do the same thing. That's so cute.
Can you post a link to your website?
Yes, Matt, you can do that, right?
Funnyfarmrescue.org.
Yes, Matt will post it maybe when we're done. www.funnyfarmrescue.org. There's my little niece. One more minute. They're like, are they done the live yet?
That's 11.
It's past 11. People are waiting to see us. And we have the people that I think brought the baby duck. They don't know that it went to the vet today. I think they came to
Debbie
see the
Denton
duck.
Debbie Denton posted our website for us.
Oh, thank you, Debbie.
Maybe she can send out thank you cards.
Well, hey, we have volunteers all the time. It's funny because people ask questions and Matt can't even see the questions sometimes. But sometimes people help answer those questions for us. All right, guys. Once they all get fed, then they kind of, look, the red one, the orange one's like, I would like to show, people would like to see me, so I'm back again. Ow, ow, ow.
Can I show the turkey?
The turkey, yes. Here, I'll go get the turkey. They're good for right now. Let's get the turkey. This is the baby turkey, Tommy, that was brought. People, you guys say hi? You gonna give it a kiss? Tucker's so good. See what I mean about acclimating your animals? Because you never know if, even it just takes a second and they could really hurt each other. So I don't keep, I'm a little more careful with him because he's learning. Okay, good boy. No. Be nice.
That's your brother.
So you always should acclimate your animals together. Don't separate them. It's kind of like that mystery makes it more crazy. So you say, it's no big deal. Come meet them. But just supervise, don't throw them in a room together and hope for the best. That's not the way to go. You work it, and then if the dog does like snap at it, you smack him on the nose. And I'm telling you, I have one dog that's a biter, Rocky. He actually is more afraid of the animals than anything, but even he isn't going and trying to kill the other animals that are in here.
All right, Cindy wants to stop in and see the birthday boy, Cindy Lewis.
Cindy Lewis wants to stop in. That's the old, the previous owner. I always say old and I say, don't mean that. Previous owner of Tucker. Uh-oh, Jesse's pee-peeing. Just peed, Matt. Way to go. You can see. So this is why I don't have rugs in my house. Oh, Matt, go let him out. Hurry up, hurry up. He's going to pee more.
He did pee more.
Oh, jeepers. So this is why I live in the house with them, but it's really the animals' houses. And now you know why I have a cleaning lady. My Irma, she deserves my rooms every week.
Everyone says thank you for all you do and for a great video.
Thanks, you guys, and thanks for tuning in. I have to go clean up some pee-pee now. If you want to come visit us, come Tuesdays and Sundays, 8 to 4 all year long. Sign a waiver online. Debbie put the link up. It's funnyfarmrescue.org. And I know the one young lady that maybe would like to foster Sadie for me. Give me a call or send me an email. Thanks, guys. Love you. See you next week.